So let me ask you, how many of you think you're great manifestors? By show of hands. Okay. Great manifestors.
Oh.
Yeah. How many of you think you're not so great manifestors? And how many of you wouldn't raise your hand no matter what question I asked? Two. Well, the truth is, and as we've just learned from all, everything you said, we're all excellent manifestors. Every single one of us. We manifest all the time. And in fact, we can't stop manifesting, just as we can't stop thinking. We constantly create our own reality with our beliefs, our thoughts, our emotional patterns, and the resulting actions. The question is, are we conscious manifestors who manifest what we want? Or are we manifesting things we don't really want? Would you agree? The first step to manifesting what we want is a clear vision. Creative professionals, as you, most of you are, know that, right? We create an image in our mind. We visualize. So let me give you an example. Not too long ago, two brothers visualized human beings flying. At the time, people laughed at them. They thought they were little locos, right? And today we can't imagine a world without airplanes. But visualizing is the first step to going where we want to go. Everything starts in our minds. And you know, I often hear people say, dreams don't come true, plans come true. Yes, and there's no plan without a dream, without a vision.
Make it happen.
Mm. Exactly. So why is visualization so powerful? Well, visualization creates a gap between where we are and where we want to be. And this motivates our subconscious mind to look out for opportunities that can bring us closer to our goal and that we might not otherwise see. And it also inspires and stimulates our mind's creativity. It inspires us to come up with new ideas. And last but not least, positive visualization also raises our vibration. And that allows us to attract the people and the resources we need to attain our goals. And that's why so many people use visualization techniques and vision boards to achieve their dreams. So what is your vision of the abundant reality you would like to create for yourself? I invite you to close your eyes for a moment and to create an image of that abundant reality. Create a vision and maybe hold that vision for a few seconds. And open your eyes. Now we have a vision. That was easy, right? But some may take a little longer, but it's not hard. And once you have a vision, it's great to have a system to support that vision. And my system is called the Powerful Leadership Transformation. And it consists of four elements: mindset, uniqueness, and we talked about uniqueness earlier, right? Body consciousness, and action. And how many of you have like a secret passion or a big passion that's not necessarily related to your business or your career? Anybody? Yeah, quite a few. Now, my big passion is dance. And there's a lot of wisdom in dance. Would you agree, Charles?
Absolutely.
And some of that wisdom flows into my system. So let me explain the powerful leadership transformation through the eyes of a dancer. Let's start with mindset. A powerful mindset allows me to walk all the way across the dance floor and ask my favorite dancer to dance with me. Hey, Julie, would you like to dance? A powerful mindset allows you to pick up the phone and ask your prospect to work with you. Or if you're in a company, to walk across the hallway and ask your boss for a raise. Two, uniqueness. I've lived in several different countries, and every single country, Germany, Spain, Portugal, Brazil, Argentina, the United States has its own dance styles, and not only one, but a myriad or a plethora of dance styles. And every single person has their own dance style. And I might not be the best dancer on this planet. I'm a dance aficionado, I was never a professional. But I have my very unique way to dance. And that's how I distinguish myself on the dance floor. And as a coach and trainer and speaker, I have my very unique way to do all these things. And no one does the same, because I have pulled all this together because of my unique background and experiences, just as you all have, and everyone in the room. So your uniqueness allows you to distinguish yourself as the expert in your company or with your business in your industry. And your uniqueness is also about being authentic, about being yourself. Be yourself. Because you know what? Everyone else is already taken. There are currently about 7.4 billion people on this planet, and not one single person has the same DNA as you have. Not one single person has the same fingerprint, and there's a good reason for that, because the world needs exactly you with that specific role that you have to offer. 3, body consciousness. Well, professional dancers warm up before they go on stage. And they do that physically and hopefully also energetically. The best dancers also warm up energetically. And every time I go on the dance floor, I try to do the same as a dance aficionado. I've never been a professional, but I like to warm up because it allows me to show up more powerfully on the dance floor. A body conscious presence allows you to show up more powerfully in the client meeting, in your presentations, on a panel. And 4, action. When I'm fully present in my body and in my power energy, when I have a powerful mindset, I can take a determined step. So in partner dance, there's typically a leader and a follower. And if I want to be the leader, for my dance partner to be able to follow me, my lead has to be focused, clear, and intentional. In business, it's the same. If you want to be an effective and successful leader, your action steps have to be clear, focused, and intentional. So both leaders in dance and leaders in business become effective and successful in their steps and in their action steps when they have a powerful mindset and presence, and when they are fully aware of their uniqueness, to an extent that competition becomes irrelevant. Doesn't matter anymore. I hope today's panel and my own insights inspired you to take the next action steps towards that abundant vision that you created for yourself just a few minutes earlier. And maybe you even find some collaboration partners here that can help you get there. You can find out more about me at transformyourperformance.com. I have work more with women, as you will see on my website. I typically work with women, but I also love teaching workshops and speaking to mixed audiences. And my workshops are designed to help people upgrade their mindset and their presence so they can create that abundant wealth, success, career, whatever it is for you, for themselves. And if you'd like to sign up for my mailing list, of course, you can do that and just send me an email through my website. I'd be happy to sign you up so you can also receive more messages, inspiring messages in your inbox. So I would like to thank you all. I am extremely honored to be here to chat with you all. Thank you for being such wonderful conversation partners. Thank you all for coming here in the middle of the afternoon and for your abundant attention. And thanks everybody again who was involved in setting this up, Julie, the entire team of Robert Allen, Jana, Kate, Pamela, who helped with registration, right? And of course, the board of IDS New York for allowing us to speak about this very important topic here today. Thank you.